How often do you get away from everything and just sit in God's presence? Thinking about Him. Not thinking about yourself or what you want or what your complaints are or what your needs are, but thinking about Him. It's just a thought. How often do you do that? Okay. Then David begins, he begins to be overwhelmed with the unsearchableness of God. And this is what David said next in verse 10. He said, "Oh God, you are so great or so gadol that all your works shall praise you. The birds in the sky itself, the sun, the moon, everything," David said, "is going to praise you." And then he said this. This caught my attention. "Oh Lord, your saints shall bless you." Your saints shall bless you. What does that mean? Who are the saints? I mean, I wanted to know that. Who are the saints? Anybody else want to know? Watch this. The saints. Okay? The term is used in the Hebrew Bible to describe individuals who are characterized by their faithfulness and devotion to God. It refers to those who are loyal to God's covenant and exhibit kindness and mercy towards others. These are saints, okay? The word can denote both a personal attribute of godliness, watch this, and a communal identity of those who are devoted to living according to God's laws and commandments. Communal identity. That kind of got me. Communal identity. So I asked the Holy Spirit, what does that mean? What do you mean? To be a saint, I have to have a communal identity. I can't have a me identity. I have to identify with you if I want to be a saint. And if I can't identify with you and you can't identify with me, we can't be saints. Because see, we want a me identity. Just me and you, God. Just, it can't be me and you. It's got to be us and Him. Because He is a God of community. He is a God of all of us, a God of we, okay? So as long as I'm competing with you, I can never identify with you. As long as I'm judging you, I can't identify with you. I have to identify with your perfection and your imperfection. Mm-hmm. Or I can't be called a saint, okay? Am I helping anybody? Does this make sense? All right? So I said, okay, Lord, I get it, but how are we supposed to bless the Lord? And exactly what is communal identity? And the Holy Spirit just spoke to me this morning and said, why don't you just keep reading? And I said, okay, then why don't I? Guess what he tells me next in verse 11. They shall, the saints, they shall speak of the glory of your kingdom. Now, kingdom is a New Testament thing, isn't it? Mm-mm. Kingdom started over there in the Old Testament. David saw the kingdom before the kingdom ever came. Thy kingdom come. It hadn't even come yet. And David's already over there talking about the kingdom. Why? Because he was meditating on God. And that's how God shows you your future. That's how God shows you things that you knew not of. That's how you get blessed. That's how eyes have not seen and ears have not heard. Not because I'm praying, God, give me a revelation, but because I'm meditating on Him. When I'm meditating on Him, He'll tell me, take that job or don't take that job. Buy that house or don't buy that house. Buy that car or don't buy that car. Marry that fool or don't marry that fool. I mean, anyway, if you'll meditate on God, He'll tell you the things that you need to know, okay? But he was meditating on God, and God showed him something that had not even yet been spoken of. He said, these saints, they're going to speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power. Kingdom, okay? Kingdom. There it is in the Old Testament. David is seeing the kingdom because he's meditating on God. I wonder what is going on in my life tomorrow that is just going to blindside me because I'm not meditating on God. I'm just worrying about it. See, this is how you stop worrying. This is how anxiety stops. What we want to do is medicate anxiety. But if we could just start teaching our kids to meditate on Him again instead of putting a tablet in their hand, then we would cure their anxiety before they ever got to where we are. I'm just trying to help somebody.